Cloud computing consists of offering computing resources such as servers and software on demand via the internet following a pay-as-you-go model, which means that instead of owning hardware and software, you can access and pay for them as a service whenever needed. Cloud computing represents the latest evolution in enterprise hardware and software delivery. In the beginning, computers were massive rudimentary machines housed in vast warehouses. They then evolved into sophisticated mainframes located in big data centers and remotely accessed via dummy terminals. Such mainframe systems are still in use today by large organizations like banks, airlines, and government agencies. The 80s ushered in the era of personal computers, democratizing access to computing resources. And of course, the 90s saw the rise of the internet, followed by the mobile revolution. Software transitioned online, with users interacting with remote servers via web browsers and mobile apps. To accommodate the exponential growth of web and mobile use, organizations had to set up and manage thousands and thousands of servers in immense data centers. Managing this kind of infrastructure is hard, it's complex, costly, and time-consuming. Hardware needs constant maintenance and upgrades, and software requires regular updates and patches. In the mid-2000s, at Amazon, IT teams recognized these challenges when managing their own infrastructure. For example, to support the online retailer's growth, they had to provision and maintain thousands of costly idle servers in anticipation of peak traffic events like Prime Day or Black Friday sales. So, in 2006, they proposed renting out their excess capacity and computing resources to customers via a new on-demand pay-as-you-go model. AWS was established as an Amazon subsidiary to operate this new cloud computing business. One of the first services they offered was S3, a cost-effective storage solution available on the internet for anybody to use. Customers could store their files in S3 and pay only for the storage capacity they actually used. S3 was a resounding success. AWS pioneered cloud computing and is still considered today the leader in the field. Other major contenders in the cloud computing market include Microsoft, Google, IBM, Oracle, and Chinese companies like Alibaba and Tencent. So, how does the cloud work? There are basically three main building block categories for any IT system: compute, storage, and networking. A cloud provider must offer solutions and options for all of them. Compute is what allows for processing data and logic. Cloud providers offer various options to run workloads, from small microservers to sophisticated high-performance machines, as well as containers and serverless computing solutions. Storage is where data is physically stored. The cloud offers virtually unlimited storage capacity and a variety of options, from simple file and object storage to all kinds of databases and data warehouses. Networking consists of the underlying infrastructure, tools, and systems needed to run and operate a network of computing resources. Cloud providers have built extensive physical networks linking their data centers and even own intercontinental undersea fiber cables linking their different regions around the globe. In addition to these building blocks, cloud providers offer an extensive set of tools, solutions, and software to streamline development, administrations, operations, cybersecurity, and more. Their goal is to be a one-stop shop for all IT needs, where everything is readily available. This is why most startups today are cloud native, allowing them to focus on their core competencies, move quickly, experiment, and innovate faster without the burden of managing the underlying infrastructure and software. At the same time, many organizations are migrating their IT infrastructure and solutions to the cloud to benefit from its agility, efficiency, and cost effectiveness. In recent years, we've witnessed another transformative domain where cloud computing has taken center stage: artificial intelligence and machine learning. The ability to instantly access immense processing power and storage capacity has enabled companies and startups to train very large and complex models on vast volumes of data. This has led to the emergence of innovative AI models such as OpenAI's GPT-4, Anthropic's Claude 2, and Google's Gemini Ultra, among others. Without the cloud, such rapid acceleration in AI innovation would likely not have been possible. Cloud providers operate on a global scale, and their expansion continues unabated year after year. We may be merely observing the initial stages of cloud computing. It is conceivable that almost everything we use in our daily lives will eventually be somehow cloud-based.